this is something you don't see every day. The trail actually just straight up connects to someone's property. Huh. That's interesting. Let's take a look at the map. Yep. Private residence. If the camera wants to focus, it probably doesn't, but I'll figure it out. Yeah, that is something that, oh. Okay, so I accidentally took the shortcut. All right. That's fine. That's the main downside to hiking in the fall. Leaves cover everything, so it can be hard to tell where the trail actually is if the blazes aren't, you know, a bright or unnatural color. And the blazes for this trail are white right now, which is not super helpful when you're trying to quickly glance around and find it. The boulder. The boulder whose name I don't remember right now, but I'm sure this map will tell me. Bigelow Boulder, yes. So that's Bigelow Boulder, all right. What a boulder. No, it's actually interesting. Geologically. Because a lot of this area is granite. And this is just a giant granite rock that came from somewhere. Has some graffiti on it, naturally. But this giant boulder slid or was carried from somewhere. Aha! Looks like somebody keeps a geocache down here. I unfortunately don't have anything to leave behind, but let's take a look. Just see the kinds of things people have been leaving. Subway pass.
Yeah, that's... Oh, so that was only a couple months ago.
Sign our names at least. The dog litter. Empty pack of camels. Let's go ahead and sign our names. It's the day today, the 31st. 31/8/22. What else we got? October 6, 22. Looking for a chicken of the woods and stumbled on this chicken of the woods. It's a type of mushroom. Gene Kelly and Cowboy. Bella FR was here. Hope you enjoy the Cabot Tact? Couple of quotes from Mary Oliver. Huh. Let's tuck all these back in the bag so they don't get too moist. something else that unfortunately wouldn't fly at a GCR park. As cool as these little things are, you know, they have regulations that they have to follow, and that is essentially litter. So it's nice to see something like, it's always nice to see something like that. That's not to say there aren't geocaches at DCR property, on DCR property rather, but they tend to be kind of out of the way. You know, they have to not be, I mean, I'm on a trail behind the boulder, I walk up and it's right there. So, you know. Someone built a little shelter here. Let's see if it holds up to BSA standards. It's fairly old. You can tell it's kind of collapsed a bit. This tree isn't resting on any. Oh, and this wood is very light. Just gonna wood louse here. This could collapse at any moment. But it does look fairly weatherproof with a decent amount of ventilation, so I don't know. If I was the Scoutcraft director and I had to judge this, I would pass it. But it is pretty old, so I don't know what it looked like when it was originally built. So I'm sure it worked out fine for whoever built it. Where is the blaze? I'm gonna guess down this way. I'm probably wrong though. I don't know. I don't see anything this way. Let's try the other direction. I don't see a blaze in either direction. And this definitely looks like I'm off trail. So, all right. See what the map says. Looks like, okay, so according to the map, that first direction across the brook is the correct way. We'll have to see. If I run into a blaze, we'll know. See, they've violated the golden rule of trailblazing. Whenever you set a blaze down, make sure it's visible from the previous blaze and the next blaze. Oh, no wonder no one comes down this way. This doesn't look like a trail at all. I mean, there are the signs of use. There are the rocks coming up over out of the soil that wouldn't otherwise be there in an area that doesn't have soil compaction. So I'm fairly confident I'm on trail. But until I see something artificial, I won't really know. Ah, here we are. Okay, so I'm back where the Bancroft Trail intersects with the blue loop again. It's apparently called Boulder Lane. Yeah, okay. Here I am. All right, well, down Boulder Lane we go to Whitney Road to Adelaide Road. I don't know, we'll figure it out. Love seeing huge natural formations like that. If this wasn't just a test video, I might have climbed up there, but I already got that shot, so I don't need another. Alright, then this should be where the yellow and red trails intersect, and the yellow trail joins red. Yep, so yellow would continue on down back that way along the red trail, but we're going to actually be taking the red trail around to the Turkey Hill parking lot, and then turn around and take the other half of the loop.
Getting some more third-person test footage with audio, kind of like I did last time, except this time the light's actually in front of me instead of behind me. Getting a little bit more test footage, third-person, kind of like I did last time, except this time the light is coming from in front of me instead of from behind me. Getting some more third-person test footage, kind of like last time, except instead the light's coming from in front of me instead of from behind me.
Interesting. No, don't see a map at this intersection. It's obviously a bike trail. One, because of the gravel on the ground, but two bikes just passed by, so the Whitney Thayer Spur. Okay. Oh, okay, and there's a map down here on the trail. They just didn't put it on the intersection itself. Alright. These things get a little complicated. Oh, Whitney Spur Rail Trail. Okay, so this is a thing that's separate from the park that just happens to go through it. Gotcha. You can actually see the property line. Ooh, center you in there. You can see the property line actually is to the edge of the Whitney Spur Trail and not on it. Okay. That's what all of those other trails are. Cool. Well, we got a blaze going that way, so we're gonna follow Turkey Hill Lane. Gee, I wonder if we're at the edge of the property line right now. I can't possibly imagine what might be giving me that impression. Also, I didn't point it out, but there's a building like 100 feet to my right. You can't see it from here, but that's where all the noise is coming from. Oh, we got a little dog park here. Huh. Okay, so that must be, there's a section on the map, I didn't point it out, but there's a section on the map that just like cuts away from the trail briefly and then cuts back in. That must be the right of way that goes through that trail, goes through that field rather. I guess I'm gonna test the zoom functions of this thing because I want to show you this. This is super cool. I'm just gonna do this handheld. I don't feel like setting up my tripod again, so there is no zoom function. I can only zoom into 1.4x. But yeah, if you look immediately center frame, there's a nest up there. Probably a hawk of some kind, but I'm not familiar enough to be able to tell. But yeah, I'll have to double check on the map. I don't know if I'm actually on Trustee's property or not. Probably, if I had to guess. Thank you. Really hope the camera's picking up all the noises right now. We've got crickets, a couple of different birds. I know the GoPro's probably filtering out the wind sound, but this is what's wonderful about nature. I know in my head that I'm that I just walked, you know, a quarter of a mile off the road just now. But if I can ignore the sounds of, I think, a leaf blower or something off to the side, it's very, very faint. I can probably convince my brain to filter it out. I forget where I was going with this, but something, something, nature, something, something alone. I'm sure I'll remember that. I'm sure I'll remember my point for a future video. Ah, okay. Yep, so we want to continue to follow the yellow, the Milliken Memorial Path, because that'll bring us back to where we parked. Without too much backtracking. Let's see. To Maple Minot Minnow? Milliken? I don't know. In affectionate memory, from one friend to another, BH 1927. Huh. I'll have to look up anything I can find about that later. This is, yeah, that's definitely, it looks like copper. It doesn't look like it's been coated or painted with anything, so. I really wish I knew more geology. So, like, I could look at this and be like, oh, this was caused by XYZ. But I just don't. Blue blazes, I didn't think I was that far yet. What does that say? Commonwealth of Massachusetts State Forest. Oh! This is the boundary with Wompatuck. Wompatuck State Forest. Okay. Yeah, this trail runs right on the border between the Whitney and Thayer woods and Mass DCR's Wompatuck State Forest. That's right. If I recall, I remember reading on one of the maps, I think it was the map all the way back in the parking, the first parking lot I came from, that there was going to be a trail that connected this trail and Wompatuck's, one of Wompatuck's loops, but due to safety reasons, it is closed. I wonder what those would be. Maybe it got washed out, I don't know. But, cool. Okay, so I was saying before, there's a path into Wompatuck that had been closed, but I guess it's not actually closed? Unless there's just another trail they were building that they just stopped building. Well, whatever. We'll explore that another day. Wow. The trail continues off that way, but I'm going to take a small detour. And I almost wonder if this is Ode's Den. Because this is... Oh, yes, it is. Yes, so I'm going to return to the trail. I'm going to show you what I just saw. The trail goes up there, and then makes a hard turn right here. Looks like it should go that way, but obviously it's been a little bit less maintained. I don't know how many people come down this way, so. But if you look, ooh, not die, if you look, there's a blaze. This is so cool. So what the blaze that I saw Where's the blaze that I saw? This one. So the blaze that I saw was this one, which I think was placed because a lot of people would walk through this way. Oh, this is so cool. Oh man, I wish I wasn't on a time constraint. I would love to just explore this whole thing. Next time. This is why I'm trying to go to parks that I haven't been to before. Through that way. When I'm doing this series. So it's not just like, oh ho hum, this is the trail that I know and I recognize. You stumble across really cool stuff like this. All right, where's the trail? Oh boy. Am I lost? Yeah, probably. Is it going that way? Yes, there it is. So this is Turkey Rock that I'm passing here on my right. It must be, because it's... Oh my goodness. Look at that. Oh, that's so cool. Again, I really, really wish I knew more about geology so I could understand, like, how does this happen, you know? Oh, that's so cool. So, let's look at the map here, show you what I just did, because I'm an idiot. So, here, right, I stopped the video, I changed the battery out from my camera, went through Roseden. Rooster Rock, excuse me, not Turkey Rock, Rooster Rock. Now I'm here. I stopped my watch here, because you're supposed to when you stop moving. And I didn't start it again until I got here. You know, I was so good about stopping and restarting my 4 miles. I was so good about stopping and restarting my fitness tracker watch in the last video. So we're just coming up to the parking lot now. I can see the gate right in front of me here. Just want to remind everybody, remember to adhere to the principles of leave no trace, take only photographs, and leave only footprints. Happy trails.